एटलीस्ट टू टाइम्स और थ्री टाइम्स योर टमी विल बी वेरी वेरी थिन. लेट्स डू अनदर आसन विच इज अ नावासन. सो नावासन, फॉर नावासन जस्ट कीप योर लेग इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. दिस लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्ट आसन. Okay, so take care. Those who have backache, please don't do Navasan. Or those who have ulcers, please don't do Navasan. Okay, so very slowly you be in Dandasan. This is also one asan which is very good for digestion if you stretch your tummy. But Navasan has a fun. So we'll go in Navasan step by step. If you find it's difficult, stop yourself there, chal. Believe me, but one of the asan which you do, you will lose your tummy and gain your digestion. Let's do slowly, very slowly, support your legs and lift them. First, you have to lift them with support. This is fine. You have to tilt yourself and lift them with support. Okay, very good. Some of you have done very well. Very slowly lift them up. Right. Very good. Some of you have done very well. And the fun starts there when you release your hand and make it parallel to your legs. And observe now the pressure on your tummy. Observe the digestion. It's fun. Observe the fun. The fun doesn't end there. Then there is an Navasan Sanchalanasan. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Opposite. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And again to the original position. Navasan. Slowly support your legs. Come back to the original position. And relax. Navasan. Next asan, which is one of the best asan as a part of the cleaning process of Mahashankha Prakshalan, is a Kagasan. So for this, you need to sit yourself. You need to make a comfortable on one leg. See the one leg, you are on toes. Other leg is completely on the ground. This way, your vertebral column is straight. Take a deep breath. Your right hand, keep it on the right side. Left hand is on the left side of the knee. Take a deep breath. Press your right hand, your two on your right knee, and twist yourself. You have taken a deep breath. Remember, you are pressing your tummy. Those who have arthritis or lumbago, they should not do it. Those who have autoimmune diseases should not do it. No for pregnant ladies at all. Remember, you have taken a deep breath and you have pressed your knees together. Come back. And breathe out. Similarly, the other way. This particular Kagasan is responsible for pushing the complete food from the colon to the rectum. Take a deep breath and press your left side slowly and twist yourself on the right. Observe the stretch in tummy, the side, and you have already taken a deep breath. Do not breathe out here. This is one of the asana where you should not breathe out. Come back and then breathe out. The Kagasan is one of the last asana for the process of Shankha Prakshalan. Okay, one of the asana which is a key asana which help to prevent the diabetes as well as the pancreas ailments is again a very famous asana, that is the Ardha Machindrasana. So in case of Ardha Machindrasana, what we should do, fold your one leg is folded on the ground, right? Now we have to hold by our left hand with two fingers our toe of right leg. This way? No. We have to hold it through the twist from this side by left hand after the twist. What is the way? But for that, you have to twist yourself. So what we need to do, take a deep breath first and slowly breathe out and hold your toe and slowly right hand towards the right, twist yourself to the right. If you are not able to hold, what you can do, you can press by your arm your knee and thigh and observe the stretch this side. Observe it. You will find that which energy cannot give you digestion. If you cannot do that, at least do this way. Hold it here, twist yourself. Ideally, the best way is to hold and take your right hand on the left side, surrounding your back. So here, when you breathe in, you will feel that you are breathing in through your tummy and not through your chest. Your right chest is completely open, left chest is completely closed. So you are breathing from one side. Let's do it from the other side. Slowly come back to the original position. Take a deep breath and breathe out. Let's do it for the right side. So again, fold your knee, twist yourself first so that you can twist as much as possible. Remember, those people who have ulcers or who are suffering from the dysentery, they should not do it. It will aggravate. Or if you have any stomach injury, you should not do it. So here, first try to press your leg and hold your toe with your hand and your left hand should be surrounding your pat. Try to twist. Keep your backbone as straight as possible. Only twisted, right? And breathe in, breathe out, gentle smile on the face. So breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. I'm sure you must be remembering that this is delivering a project and the development CR is not approved, right? So it's little bit challenging in the first few days, but over the period of time you will enjoy this. So breathe out, come back to its original position, relax your hands. Take a deep breath and come back to the original position. Again, take a deep breath and breathe out. Let's have a couple of asana with the supine position, which are very helpful for digestion. Believe me, today you are going to definitely have a very good digestion in your day. Do not overeat today. So to avoid that, we'll also go for the asana which are, or the kriyas which are responsible for reducing your acidity. But before that, let's have some relaxation asana. So be in a supine position, some relaxation asana. This is also known as Jathara Parivartan asana. So fold your legs and widen your hands in line with the shoulders. Take a deep breath, tilt your legs on left and your neck on right. Jathara Parivartan asana. Observe the stretch you have in your tummy, the muscles of the tummy. Slowly go on the right side, tilt your legs on the right and your neck on the left. Your tummy should be protruding. Observe the stretch and relaxation you have. But at the same time, stretching up tummy. Come back. Very important asana, which is for the relaxation, is also known as Supta Baddha Konasana. So in this case, you just need to touch the foot to each other and slowly relax them. This is also giving you a less acidity. If you have any cramp, bring them to original position and very slowly relax it. Apart from the Supta Baddha Konasana, you can also have the Supta Sukhasana. In case of Supta Sukhasana, this is also good for reducing your acidity. Supta Sukhasana. So just fold your legs like Sukhasana and relax yourself. Supta Sukhasana. There are asanas like Matsyasana, then we have Uttitpadasana, Sarvangasana, and also the Halasana, which are very good for digestion. In the interest of time, whenever we will have a detailed session on digestion, a whole week only on digestion, we'll conduct them. We'll conduct many other asanas. Come back to the original position. Let's get up and let's do some kriya which will control our jatharagni or our juices of tummy. So first, breathe out. Lock your chin and you have to throw your tummy out, Agni Sar, right? So Agni Sar. So take a deep breath, then breathe out, lock your chin and throw the tummy out. No breathing. Come back and breathe in. Let's do it again. Take a deep breath. Breathe out. Lock your chin. And start Agni Sar. Remember, whenever you do Agni Sar, you should do Moolabandh. Let's do it again with Moolabandh. You should have definitely a supporter along with your inner. Take a deep breath. Breathe out. Lock your chin. Come back. Take a deep breath. Breathe out. One of the best way for anaerobic metabolism increase is Agnisar, as well as to control our digestive juices. One of the best is Agnisar. Believe me, the people who have very good digestion, they have very good skin, and also they have very good agility as well as enthusiasm. One last one which we will go for is to reduce our acidity. This is again a Sheetali we can do. Okay, so Sheetali, for Sheetali, just roll your tongue and breathe in by mouth, gallop there again. Gallop there, swallow there, and breathe out by nose. Chitkari, just touch your teeth each other and breathe in through mouth. And one last one which generally we should do after our lunch or dinner. That is the only one which we should do after our lunch or dinner, and that is Vayusar. So what we need to do, like a Kaki Mudra, we have to breathe in by mouth and breathe out by nose. But in doing so, it will actually flood the air inside our tummy. So let's do it. Remember to have Mool Bandh. How to check you have done it correctly? Very simple. Touch your tummy with your palm inside and try to belt. And observe, your tummy will be very light, very light. Let's take a deep breath. Close your eyes. Remember, we are done Trikonasana, Surya Namaskar, Sun Salutation, Parshva Konasana. We also done the Virasana, Warrior Pose. Then we have done the sitting asanas, Navasana, Vajrasana. We also have done Ardha Machindrasana, Kagasana, Naman Mudra. Many asanas we have done. Agnisar, Sheetali, Sheetkari, Vayusar. Observe your tummy with the closed eyes from inside. Observe the feeling you have at Manipur Chakra, at the belly button. You must be feeling light there. You must be feeling that you are under completely a good digestion power. I'm sure each one of you must be thirsty. That is a sign of increase of digestion and metabolism. Rub your palms. Rub them on your neck, on your ear, your face. Slowly with imagination of very good digestion, please open your eyes. Questions, please.
Thank you so much, Raghavendraji. I'm surprised, and you know, I'm so glad to see so many asanas done on stomach today morning, and today the digestion for all these people who have done the asanas is going to be extremely well. And as you advised to have a light meal for the entire day today, as we have done exercises on stomach, as you advised in the during your session. So would request participants to ensure that you follow that. And we see if you have any questions. When can we have breakfast after this session?
Give just 5-10 minutes, okay, at least. I know you must be hungry now because you worked heavily on your tummy. And remember a formula, CCQTM for digestion. The formula is CCQTM, you can write it down. What is C is content, okay, and second C is craving. Content should be proper. Do not eat too much of high glycemic index carb. Second C is a craving. Unless and until you have a craving, don't eat. Q is a quantity. Don't eat quantity more than required. You should be half empty stomach. T is a time. So your question was regarding time. Can I eat it after this? Don't eat immediately. Otherwise you will overeat. Just stay for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, and after that take a sip of water and then start eating. So time. QTM. M is metabolism. So M, metabolism is in our hands. If we do yoga, metabolism is good. Content is in our hand. Craving is not in our hand. It is directed through metabolism and yoga. Q is in our hand. Quantity is in our hand. And T is also in our hand. So those things which are in our hand, you can definitely control them. So T you can control. CC.
Okay, so that answers. Okay, so that answers the question. And we have a question. How much time do we need Vajrasana per day?
Yeah, you can do as much as possible. It is said in epics that even 3 hours 36 minutes is also you can do it. Provided your leg should not get numb more than a limit. Okay. So that is the only thing. Second thing is you should not have any autoimmune disease or cartilage or tendons problems, or you should not have any degenerative diseases of muscles. So otherwise you can do it. The Vajrasana is the only asana, again repeat, which can be done 3 hours 36 minutes. Don't do other asanas 3 hours 36 minutes. Very important, very good question.
Okay, how does Vayusara help? Do we swallow the air and keep inside?
Yeah, we swallow the air. Actually, there are air bubbles in our tummy, stomach. and these are touching here and there, and because of their osmotic pressure, their air pressure, they are not able to come out. They are there itself somewhere, and you know they come out afterwards. But before that, as we have taken a meal, right, they are there, they should be come out so that our tummy can get a complete space to churn out. So that's why it is done after the meal, so that the bubble can fuse together and come out as a belch. So that is the advantage of Vayusar. So we swallow the air, that is true.
What are the benefits of Agnisar?
Yeah, see, in Agnisar you have an anaerobic condition where you are breathing out, and now you are throwing the tummy out. You know, whenever there is an anaerobic condition, if you are a biochemist, check this Embiden-Merov pathway, okay, it is a pyruvic acid pathway. Before the tricarboxylic pathway, it runs, and this particular pathway, which operates in anaerobic way, as a result of it, there will be reduction of fat on your tummy, as well as you are moving your tummy completely, okay, up and down, which actually increase the gastrointestinal motility, what we say responsible for digestion, and that's why it's very important. So there are n number of advantages. You control your craving, as well as if it is less, you increase your craving because of a proper motility of your GI. Second, you reduce your tummy fat. Third, you are actually giving a jerks to your pancreas, which is there, as well as your adrenergic gland, which is there responsible for adrenaline. So your adrenaline is controlled. You have four different hormones which are coming out, which are secreting of pancreas. So all these four hormones, including the insulin, somatostatin, glucagon, all those are controlled. So Agnisar is one key for the digestion.
Okay, we have a question. Can we do Vayusar after meals?
Yeah, you have to do Vayusar after meals only.
Okay, how can people suffering from cervical spondylosis perform Agnisar Kriya?
Yeah, so cervical spondylosis people, very important again, they should not bend forward, okay? They should keep their tummy straight, their backbone straight as a result. And only thing is, they cannot lock their chin. Very important, they cannot lock their chin. So what they need to do, that they need to have mulband, they need to stop their breathing, and they can do in a light way, this way. Very good question. I think this is the level 3 question in yoga exam. Very good. Who has asked this question?
Our name.
Very good. Whoever is there. Very good question. I think this question, you have to modify the
question
process.
From.
Yeah.
Question from J. Chandrasekhar.
J. Chandrasekhar. Thank you. Thank you so much for this question.
Okay, then we have a question which was related to any specific yoga for reducing excessive pitta?
Sorry, my computer is locked. I will
Raghavendra
just unlock.
Can you hear me?
Just a minute, my computer is locked. I think it is more than 1 hour.
Okay.
Just a minute, I'll unlock it. Yeah, please.
Any specific yoga for reducing excessive pitta? Question from Kalpak.
Yeah. Shitali and Shitkari, right? This is one. Second, even the Agnisar reduces pitta. Third one is the Supta Baddha Konasana, which we have just seen. That is the third one. One more is a Kandarasan, which also gives. Very important is Dhauti. You can have a Dhauti in the morning, which reduces Pitta, provided you don't have any blood pressure. Okay, so Dhauti you can do, it is very effective. So it reduces Pitta. And Sukta, what you can say, the Sukta Sukhasan is very good for reducing the Pitta, along with the Jathara Parivartanasan. Okay, it reduces the Pitta. And one more is the Madhya, okay, Madhya Ujjayi.
A question from Ankita. I did not get burps after Vayusar. Is it bad?
Yeah. So it's of course this is not a forum to analyze. But as you have said, I'm answering you. Please pardon me if I'm wrong or it's too much of stretch. But of course it is a personal question. With the rider, with that rider, I say many of the kapha pradhan people, they won't get belching, they won't get that because they are kapha pradhan, so they will be relaxed and they will be always happy people. Okay, so they will be always happy, and generally these kind of people, they are managers who don't get belch after Vayusar. Second thing is that if you have no pitta, high pitta, then you may not get that. Third thing is that if you don't have any kind of air going inside when you breathe in Vayusar, you won't get belch. Okay, or you have not done it properly. Suppose you have done it very slowly, so naturally the air goes more inside the lungs than in tummy, so you won't have that. Okay, so but there is nothing wrong in it. Okay, please be aware, there is nothing wrong in it. It's perfectly right. The body is performing yoga according to the setup of that body. Right? It's not like that it is wrong. You are not getting belch. There are almost 30 to 40% of people, 80% of the managers, they will not get the belch.
We have a question from Lakshmi Priya. When I focus on mood band, the stomach flapping is not easy and cannot perform as it was done without mood band.
Yeah, that's a very good question. That proves that you have tried mood band. Probably some people may not have. So it is a practice, matter of practice, because when you stretch or compress the genital, perineal as well as the anal muscles, it's very difficult. That is the reason mood band is a process where it actually activates the kundalini. So it's not a simple process, and the muscles which are